Hang on, hang on.
Clap your hands! Clap your hands! Clap your hands!
Hey, City Kids, it's me, Pastor B, coming at ya. I hope you had an incredible week. We can't wait to worship with you. Guess what's behind me? It's a Christmas tree. Now listen, we're actually not yet in the season of Christmas. That's still coming up. This is what's called the season of Advent. Advent is right before Christmas. It's the weeks leading up to Christmas, and it's all about the coming of Jesus into the world. And so we are gonna learn about Jesus, we're gonna sing about him, and soon I'm gonna see you on the other side. See you soon.
Hey, City Kids. So this morning, we're going to be singing some songs that are in our theme of Advent and Christmas for this time of year. So we're going to sing a couple songs. I hope you like them. This first one is called Go Tell It on the Mountain. So sing with me. Morning. Thanks for hanging out with us, and we're going to sing another one. Do you guys know the song, Joy to the World?
Oh, yes!
You do? Okay, we'll sing along with you. Ready? One, two, three.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing.
Sounds so good today. Thanks for joining us for this sing-song sing-along, and we'll see you next time.
Good morning, boys and girls. It's Miss Ashley here with you again on Sunday morning. And man, we're in a new season now. Can you believe it? Who just had Thanksgiving? Did anyone eat a lot of turkey? What's your favorite thing for Thanksgiving? I don't know, guys. Shout it out. What's your favorite thing? Ooh, do you know what mine is? I love sweet potatoes. I live for sweet potato casserole. It's my most favorite thing in the whole world. I'm so glad everyone had a good Thanksgiving, even if it looked how it normally looks for you this year. Maybe it looked a little bit different. Maybe some of you ate Thanksgiving outside or had a smaller crowd. Maybe some of you were able to travel and see your family still, and that's so great. I'm just so glad to have you guys back here with me for our Sunday lesson. And today's a little bit different because there's no little cartoon introduction for us, because Miss Ashley wants to share something with you about the time of year that we find ourselves in for our church calendar. Does anyone know what happens the very first Sunday after Thanksgiving is over? Anyone? If you said Advent, you are so right. Today is the very first Sunday in Advent. And you might wonder, what is Advent exactly? Well, Advent is a season of waiting. It's where we're waiting for the coming of Jesus. It's to represent the 400 years that God's people, the Israelites, waited for Jesus to come as a baby. There was 400 years where they didn't really hear from God. All they got was a lot of silence. So they didn't have this connection with him that they had before. And they're just waiting and waiting for God to fulfill his promise through Jesus. And we know that he does fulfill his promise by sending Jesus to earth as a baby. And the way that we remember that season of waiting is by celebrating Advent. It helps us remember that it's really hard to live in this world without the hope of Jesus. It helps us to remember about what it would be like if Jesus hadn't been born. So during the Sundays in Advent, we're going to celebrate each Sunday one thing that we're waiting for Jesus to bring to us. So if you had the chance to get an Advent like bag of activities from us on a recent Sunday, I'm going to show you something that's in that bag that you guys get to create. And I'll give you a few different ways you can create it. If you didn't have a chance to pick up an activity bag, if you would like one, please, please, please reach out to me or Miss Lydia and we will figure out how to get you one. If you're joining us from far away, maybe you don't live in South Florida, I bet you guys can come up with some really fun activities, and I'll try to share one each week that you guys can do as a family as well. So this is what we might remember, what we might think of during Advent. We light a candle to remember each Sunday something that Jesus is going to bring. So when baby Jesus is born, he is going to bring us peace. I think I'm starting on the wrong one. It's hope is the first Sunday. It's love is going to be the second Sunday. It's joy is the third one. And then peace is on the fourth Sunday of Advent. And then after the fourth Sunday is the next thing that comes is Christmas Day, when we celebrate the birth of Jesus. So I want you to guys, you guys can create this today if you want. You can create the whole Advent wreath and put all your decorations and all the candles on if you want. If you want to make the wreath and decorate it, but maybe you only put the flames on the Sunday that we're celebrating that word, you're welcome to do that as a way to like light your Advent wreath with us each week. So feel free to do it however you guys want. But like I said, today we're celebrating and thinking about hope, how Jesus, his birth brings us hope. And one of the ways that his birth brought us hope is because we finally had an answer, right? Those Israelites that had been waiting for 400 years without hearing from God, all they had was silence. Their hope is realized, right? That Jesus is here. He is going to save the world. He is here to save the world from its sin, to save the people from all their wrongdoing. And I think, guys, I don't even think they knew how good it was when Jesus showed up. They didn't even know how good it was going to get. But one way we can remember hope is maybe as a family this week, you can think of some ways. How can you share that hope of Jesus with people around you? And I know we're not like, probably not too many people are traveling a ton, or maybe you've gotten a lot closer with your neighbors through this, but I want you to think about some ways that you can share the hope of Jesus with others in your neighborhood. Now, That might be directly telling them about Jesus. That might be just sharing time with them. It might be sharing what hope means to you. It might just, I don't know, there's so many ways that you can do it. And I have no doubt about your creativity. So I want you guys to think about that as a family today. How can you share hope with other people around you? And like I said, it might be your neighbors, it might be people at your school, it might be family members, but I want you to think about how you can share hope, right? That's the candle we're focusing on today. How can you share hope with those around you? And I'm going to quiz you next week, okay? What does Advent really mean? Okay, Advent, that word Advent, means coming, okay? We are waiting during the season for the coming of Jesus. So I'm going to quiz you next week. We'll see who remembers, okay? And remember, if you have any questions, you need anything, please, 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 please let Miss Lydia or I know. We would love to help you in any way that we can. All right, I hope you guys have a great first Sunday in Advent. I'm so excited to be here with you guys, and I hope you have a wonderful week. All right, bye.
Hey, City Kids, hope you enjoyed that worship service today. We learned a lot today about Jesus. I want you to remember that Jesus loves you this week. May his love and his peace go before you, and I'll see you real soon.
Clap your hands!